Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics. Today we will learn about off-wave rectifier. In earlier video, we discussed about alternating current and direct current. Alternating current repeatedly changes its direction, while direct current flows in only one direction. To convert alternating current into direct current, we use a device called rectifier. This process of converting AC into DC is called rectification. Rectifiers are designed by using a diode or a group of diodes. Rectifiers are essentially of two types, off-wave rectifier and full-wave rectifier. Off-wave rectifier uses only one diode, while a full-wave rectifier uses multiple diodes. A off-wave rectifier is the simplest form of a rectifier. It uses only one diode for the transformation of AC input into DC output. In previous tutorial of PN junction diode, we saw that semiconductor diode allows current flow in forward direction from anode to cathode, but not in the reverse direction. This feature of conducting current in one direction makes diode ideal for rectification. A off-wave rectifier circuit allows only off-cycle of the input AC signal, while the another off-cycle is blocked. That's why it is called off-wave rectifier, because it passes only off of the input AC supply. Whenever alternating voltage applied across this circuit during positive off cycle of AC input, the diode is forward biased as the anode is positive with respect to cathode. So the diode acts as a closed switch and the positive off cycles will appear across this load resistor. During the negative off cycle, the diode is reverse biased as the anode is negative with respect to the cathode. So the diode acts as an open switch and the negative off cycles does not appear across the load resistor. Thus the off-wave rectifier allows only positive off cycles and blocks negative off cycles of input AC voltage. Hence the continuous sine wave input will convert it into pulsating positive pulse trains at the output. If the diode in the off-wave rectifier is reversed during negative off-cycle, the diode conducts current, and during positive off-cycles, it blocks current flow. As a result, negative off-cycles will appear at the output. Like this, we can construct negative off-wave rectifier. So far in our analysis, we have assumed that the diode in the rectifier circuit is an ideal diode. But now let's consider the forward voltage drop across the diode. Let's assume that this diode is a silicon diode, so it has a forward voltage drop of 0.7 volts. Now the diode will get forward biased only when the input voltage is more than threshold voltage of 0.7 volts. Hence, during positive off cycle of input signal, the output waveform will appear after 0.7 volts. And the peak voltage is less than Vp, that is Vp minus 0.7 volts. And during negative off cycle of input AC voltage, because of reverse bias on diode, the output voltage will be zero. In most of the cases, input peak voltage must be much larger than forward voltage drop, so that we may get output waveform much closer to the ideal waveform. Here the off-wave rectifier waveforms on the input side and pulsating DC output after rectification is shown. A cycle can also be specified in terms of angular measurement. In that case, one complete cycle is spread over 360 degrees or 2 pi radians. So off cycle is 180 degrees or pi radians. the output pulsating DC frequency of off-wave rectifier is equal to the input frequency. F out equals to F in. For example, if the input frequency is 100 Hz, then frequency of output pulsating DC will also be 100 Hz. Now let's derive the various performance related formulas for a off-wave rectifier. Let's start with average value of off-wave rectifier. Average value equals to area of a unit cycle divided by base length of a unit cycle. Negative off cycles are absent in the output of a off-wave rectifier. So the waveform can be mathematically expressed during positive off for time period 0 to T by 2 as Vm sin omega t. While for the negative off from time period T by 2 to T is equal to 0. So the average value can be given as 1 by T integration 0 to T Vt dt. If we insert the value of Vt, then we can write the average voltage as 1 by T integration 0 to T by 2 Vm sin omega t dt. Now insert base length as pi and 2 pi instead of T by 2 and T. So we can write this equation as 1 by 2 pi integration 0 to pi Vm sin omega t dt. That equals to Vm by 2 pi, and if you take the integration of sin omega t, that equals to minus cos t with limits from 0 to pi. So we will get average value as Vm by 2 pi minus cos pi plus cos 0. That equals to 2 Vm by 2 pi or Vm by pi. So in this way we will get average value of off-wave rectifier as Vm by pi or 0.318 into Vm. Now let's discuss about average current. Whenever this diode is conducting, some finite amount of current will flow through the circuit. Here Vm is the peak amplitude of sinusoidal wave. Then the peak amplitude of current Im can be given by expression Vm by RL. If you look the output waveform of current, it looks very similar to the voltage waveform. And mathematically it can be represented like this. So if we find the average value of current, then it will be Im by pi. That equals to Vm divided by pi multiplied with RL. Next parameter, RMS value. The RMS value of any given signal is expressed by square root of 1 by t integration 0 to t v square t dt. And if we insert this Vt in this expression and if we evaluate this equation, then RMS value of off-wave rectifier will come out as Vm divided by 2. Next parameter, peak inverse voltage. It is the maximum voltage across the diode in reverse biased condition. Here Vm is the positive peak amplitude of the applied sine wave input. Then during negative half cycle, the maximum voltage across the diode in reverse biased condition will be minus Vm. So the off-wave rectifier peak inverse voltage equals to Vm. We must check PIV rating of the diode before selecting the diode for rectifier. PIV rating of the diode must be higher than the applied input voltage. Otherwise, the diode gets damaged. Next parameter, ripple factor. Ripple is the unwanted AC component remaining when converting AC voltage into DC voltage. Ripple factor determines how well a off-wave rectifier can convert AC voltage into DC voltage. Ripple factor is the ratio between RMS value of AC input voltage to the output DC voltage of the rectifier. Ripple factor can be quantified by using the formula gamma equals to square root of Vrms divided by Vdc whole square minus 1. The ripple factor of off-wave rectifier is equal to 1.21. The ripple in the output can be reduced by using filter circuit. Just by connecting a capacitor across the load resistor, we can smooth out the ripples in the output waveform. Now let's understand how this circuit works. Just assume that this diode is an idle diode. Initially, the capacitor is uncharged. During the first quarter cycle of positive off, the diode is forward biased and acts as a closed switch. So through this diode, the capacitor starts charging. The charging of capacitor continues until the input reaches its peak value. At this point, the capacitor voltage equals to Vp. After the input voltage reaches to its peak voltage, input voltage begins to decrease. As soon as input voltage is less than Vp, the voltage across the capacitor exceeds the input voltage. Because of this, the voltage at the cathode of the diode exceeds its anode voltage. Due to this, the diode is reverse biased and simply acts as an open switch. So, during this period of input signal, the charge across the capacitor will get discharged through load resistor RL. So, our output waveform will appear like this. The capacitor keeps on discharging until the charge in the capacitor Vc equals to Vin. When the next peak arrives at input, the diode conducts briefly and recharges the capacitor to the peak value. And again, output voltage equals to peak voltage Vp. If we analyze the input and output waveforms, we will get this type of output waveform. These slopes in the output shows discharging of the filter capacitor and the peak shows charging of the capacitor. So here consider this time T1 as discharging period of the capacitor and this time T2 as charging time of the capacitor. Here we are assuming that RC time constant of the filter circuit is much larger than the time period of the waveform. So, by using larger value capacitors or by properly increasing the RC time constant of the filter circuit, we can increase the discharging time of the capacitor. Hence, we can also reduce the ripples in the output waveform. If the RC time constant is lesser than the time period of the waveform, then the capacitor discharges quickly. And this increases the ripples in the output. To avoid this problem, we should always check the RC time constant of the filter circuit. Next parameter of off-wave rectifier is efficiency. Efficiency defines how efficiently the AC input power is converted into the DC output power. The efficiency of off-wave rectifier is 40.6%. It means that from input AC power, only 40.6% is converted into output DC power. These are the performance parameters of off-wave rectifier. These parameters can be improved by using full-wave rectifier. We will discuss full-wave rectifier in another video. Now let's see some applications of off-wave rectifier. Off-wave rectifier can be used for signal demodulation of amplitude modulated signals. The rectification process enables the original signals can be recovered from the amplitude modulation. Off-wave rectifier can be used as a signal peak detector for detecting the peak voltage of an incoming waveform. That's all about off-wave rectifier. If you have learned from this video, please do mention them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe and turn on notifications for more such videos. Have a nice day.